الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him. We seek His aid and we ask for His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evil consequences of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can lead astray, and whomsoever Allah leaves to go astray, none can guide. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah alone, who has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. The best speech are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is that of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the worst thing in the religion are the newly invented matters, because all the newly invented matters in religion are innovation and bid'ah, and every innovation and bid'ah is misguidance, and it leads to the hellfire. يقول الله عز وجل في محكم كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير إن بطش ربك لشديد إنه هو يبدئ ويعيد وهو الغفور الودود ذو العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ. This is Surah Al-Buruj that most of us know of. And a lot of us know it very well and what it talks about. And it has the answers to the questions that go through our minds in these times. When the Muslims are being tried and being tortured and being killed and being humiliated and being chased out of their lands. What is happening in Aleppo, in Halab, is not new. The Muslim Ummah has been going through this. For the last 100 years, this has been happening regularly. And every time we've been crying our hearts and our eyes out, and things have been happening over and over again. And we seem to get so much emotional when these things are happening, but once it's over, we go back to our old ways. And we forget the lessons that we are meant to learn from these events. And this is why such events and such atrocities are bound to happen over and over and over and over and over and over again until we learn the lessons and we turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's nothing that nothing happens in this universe, in this world, randomly. We live in a world, in a universe where there are no mistakes. And this surah gives us the answers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts by making an oath and swearing by some of His magnificent creation. And these are the positions and the arcs of the stars. Where the stars are positioned, Allah is directing our attention to the greater universe, to the bigger universe. So when you are taken over by such a hardship and such atrocities, turn to the magnificent and profound and great creation of Allah, where you feel yourself like nothing compared to this humongous and profound creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ. And if you think this is the whole story, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ, and the promised day. Allah is saying this is not the end. This is not the whole story. This is just one page in this small chapter in the bigger book of life. So don't be sucked in completely by the atrocities that are taking you over, by these crimes that are happening. Don't let them suck you in and make you lose perspective about the reality of life and why Allah puts you on this earth here and why Allah is allowing these things to happen. The story is not over yet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ. And indeed the real life is the life of the hereafter, because this life is just like a dream. It's just like a mirage. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this life as a mirage and a delusion. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ. And Allah swears by the day of judgment, the promised day. That's the promise. That's when everything will fall into place. This is when the scales will get even. This is where everyone will get their rights. This is where every criminal will get their punishment. And every victim will get their rights. Things have not been settled yet. And they are not settled yet. And there are so many disputes from thousands and thousands and thousands of years before that have not been settled yet, but they will never be forgotten. The story is not over yet. وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ. And a witness and the witnessed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making clear that everything is witnessed. Everything has been recorded. Over everything there is a witness. And these accounts, and these atrocities, and these events, and these crimes, and these wars will be brought back on the day of judgment and will be played out in front of everyone to see. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا كُنَّا نَسْتَنْسِخُ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. We have a copy. We were making a real copy. The exact copy of what you did will be played out in front of you on the day of judgment. So everything is witnessed. قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ. May death, may woe be upon the people who have dug the trench out. And Allah here is referring to an incident that happened
to the early believers who followed Isa ibn Maryam, Jesus, the son of Mary, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, who remained upon the true message of Al-Masih alayhi salam, upon the true message of Jesus, peace be upon him. They remain truthful to it when it has been changed. And the people who changed it had power and had a whole empire behind them. So they decided to annihilate the believers and wipe them out of the face of earth. So they dug out the trench, a huge, massive trench, and they lit a huge, massive fire. And then they started throwing the believers into it so they could taste the heat of the fire before they die. They didn't even choose a merciful death for them, a painless death for them. It's a death that takes time, where the body burns slowly until the soul leaves that body. And who was thrown into it? Believing men and women and children. They were thrown into it. And the reason for that, as Allah states in the surah, that they believe in Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believe in the truth that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ النَّارِ ذَاتِ الْوَقُودِ. The fire that they lit with so much fuel and wood. إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُدُ. When they sat on it and they witnessed it and they conducted that crime and that atrocity. Allah is a witness over all of this. And Allah keeps that in a record and will not go in vain. إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودُ وَهُمْ عَلَى إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودُ وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ. And they were witnessing what they were doing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was witnessing the crimes they committed against the believers. How they threw them into the fire. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the authentic hadith about these people who were thrown into the trench when they were burnt into the fire. They willfully submitted to their fate. Why? Because they knew that was the time, it was their time to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this was the end of their pain, the end of their suffering. So they could see beyond their affliction. They could see beyond their pain. They could see beyond that fire. And except for one woman who had her little child, her infant baby in her hands, and she was so fearful of allowing herself to be pushed into the hellfire, so she hesitated. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the little baby to speak out. And he said, Ya Ummah, innaki ala al-haq. He said, Oh mother, you are upon the truth. You are upon the truth. Was Allah witnessing that? Was Allah seeing that? Did Allah hear all of this? Yes, indeed. Isn't Allah merciful? Beyond our imagination. Beyond our expectation. Isn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the Almighty, the All-Powerful? Couldn't He put an end to that? Yes. But His knowledge, His mercy, His wisdom stipulated that this thing happens so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes people and elevates them into paradise. Because probably in their life they have not done anything significant. Probably in their lives they have done so many sins. They have transgressed the limits of Allah. They've lived their life negligent of Allah. Or maybe they tried their best, but they haven't done enough to reach a high state in paradise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for them in the eternal life. So He makes them suffer for a couple of years, a number of years, a couple of days, a few weeks, or maybe for a lifetime. What is it, 70 years compared to eternity? An endless number of years. So Allah causes them to suffer for a little while. For this parenthesis in eternity, Allah causes them to suffer. Why? To give them happiness, ultimate happiness in the eternal life, where they can enjoy the nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His blessings in paradise that will not be interrupted by fear or pain or sadness or any negative feeling. وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَن يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. The only thing they had against them in order to throw them into the fire, to kill them, to besiege them, to bombard them, and burn them and demolish the buildings on top of their heads. The only reason was that they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the message. Why do you think the whole world has left the people of Syria, the people of Burma, and the people of Iraq, and the people of Egypt, and the Muslims in different parts of the world? Why do you think the people have left them for their faith, for their fate? Why do you think people are fighting for animal rights when human beings have no rights in these lands? Why? It's their belief. It's their belief. But we don't need the whole world when Allah is on our side. We don't need anyone for that matter when Allah is on our side. The people who go through hardship and they fall in despair, and sometimes they commit suicide and life becomes unbearable, it's that's because these people have no faith. But with the people of faith, whatever happens, we have Allah. Whatever happens, we know that Allah will make it work for us, even if it's overwhelmingly painful and atrocious. So we see beyond our calamity. We see beyond the fire. We see beyond the atrocity. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا. Those who have tried, those who have committed crimes and atrocities against those who have believed, the males and the females. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here specifically the males and the females, because it's usually the weaker ones that are taken advantage of, the weaker ones that are being tortured and killed in these wars, mainly the women and the children and the old men. And then these people who commit these atrocities against the believers, and they do not repent to Allah, and they do not regret their crimes and turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fix what they have corrupted. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns them, and Allah promises a severe punishment for them. فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمُ. For them will be the torment and the chastisement of the hellfire. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْحَرِيقُ. And for them will be the burning fire that will scorch them and burn them forever. Forever. Non-stop. There will be no end for that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are completely overwhelmed by this calamity and the death of these innocent people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to you, look beyond that. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Those who have believed in Allah and they have done righteous deeds, for these people there will be gardens of paradise beneath which rivers flow. ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. That's the biggest victory. That's the biggest win. That's the ultimate achievement. So you feel sad, and you're rightly so, feel sad for them, feel the pain, feel their suffering, and you're justified in that. But you should not neglect the fact that these people will be recompensed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they turn to their Lord, when they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't have to worry about these people, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let down anyone who believes in Him. Allah will not let down anyone who trusted Him, anyone who held on to their faith. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns our attention to something very important, because oftentimes we are caught up by the immediate reality, by what happens to us, by what happens to our brothers and sisters, what happens to other people, weak people all over the globe and throughout history. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns our attention to probably the most pressing and most important fact, yet most of humanity seem to forget it and seem to neglect it. And that's the most important element in existence. And this is what we will explain shortly. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, إن بطش ربك لشديد. Indeed, the punishment and the power of your Lord is so magnificent and powerful and overwhelming. So don't doubt the power of Allah. Some people get caught up in what is happening to the negligence of the might and the power and the wisdom and the knowledge of Allah. And they start questioning the decree of Allah. They start questioning the wisdom of Allah. They start questioning the mercy of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us against that. And we said previously, in a previous khutbah, that it's important that we should not get caught up completely in the immediate circumstances. Because what happens and what your eyes can capture and what your ears can hear is not the full truth, is not the full reality, it's only a fraction. It's only a tiny bit of the whole spectrum of reality. There are other things that are happening. There is the world of the unseen and it's all connected, and you should not neglect that because this is consequential. This is consequential. So you should be mindful of the power and the punishment of Allah. So if you question Allah's mercy or Allah's wisdom or Allah's power or Allah's support to the believers, then you have fooled yourself. You have fooled yourself, and you know that you have to recalibrate. You have to refocus. You have to adjust yourself back to see the ideal view of reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He is in charge and He is allowing these things to happen, He must be doing this for the sake of these own people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to the believers after the battle of Uhud, when the Muslims have been injured, 70 of the best companions have been killed and have been martyred. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا. When a calamity has hit you, that double of it has hit the ones or your enemies before, you say, where is this from? قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. Say, it's from you. It's from your own selves, from your own shortcomings, your own weaknesses. And in a previous verse in the same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. Allah wants to take martyrs, to elevate them in paradise, to put them in high positions in paradise. How are they going to reach those levels if they are not martyred for the sake of Allah? And the Prophet ﷺ said in a famous hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints a high place, a high station for someone in paradise, and this person doesn't do enough to qualify to that level. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tries them and sends hardship their way so that they achieve that high level. Yes, they will go through pain. Yes, they will go through so much torture and persecution. But Allah will always be in charge. Inna batsha rabbika lashadid. Innahu huwa yubdi'u wa yu'id. He's the one who begins life, and He's the one who ends it, and He's the one who starts it again on the day of judgment. So don't think this life is the whole story. Be mindful of the akhirah. That's only one chapter, and Allah will make everything turn in the side of the believers. So see the whole story. See the whole thing together. إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ. He's the one who's forgiving and who is loving and merciful to the believers. الْوَدُودُ. There is so much love and compassion in this verse. Compassion to who? To the believers. The ones that are tortured, yes. The ones that are being humiliated, yes. The ones that are being pushed out of their land, yes. The ones who are starving, yes. And the Prophet ﷺ explains in the hadith, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا أَصَابَ مِنْهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a servant, Allah will try him. Allah will take some of what he has or what she has. And Allah will make sometimes life hard for them. Why? Because Allah wants to protect them from this dunya, so it doesn't engulf them and it doesn't suck them in. وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ ذُو الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدُ. He is the owner and the master of the great throne. Allah is in charge. Allah is the Almighty. Never lose hope in Allah. And never question the power and might of Allah. Never question the mercy of Allah and the wisdom of Allah, and never question the decree of Allah. So what He causes to happen is the best scenario ever. Any other possibility would be negative. Any other possibility would be counterproductive. Any other possibility would be against the believers. So Allah always chooses the best for the believers, even though we can't see it. Even though they are going through through pain and through hardship and through torture and through all of these sufferings. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirms that and He says, if you question this, listen to what Allah says about Himself. فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ Allah does what He wants. Allah does what He wants. So don't think that these things are happening against the will of Allah. Don't ever think that these things are happening and Allah doesn't want them. Allah, through His wisdom and knowledge and mercy and love for the believers, allows these things to happen, creates them, and allows them to come into existence. Why? Because there is something beyond this. There is something far greater. There's a greater reality beyond this. And if you hold on to your faith, if you hold on to your iman, if you hold on to your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be able to get that recompense afterwards. And that's the beauty of the challenge of this life. And that's the test of this life. That you have to believe in something that your heart knows, but you can't see it. You're going through the pain, but you're experiencing the mercy of Allah at the same moment. You can feel it, even though you are going through the torture and the pain and the hardship. فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you question, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ الْجُنُودِ Have you seen those who came before? فِرْعَوْنَ وَثَمُودُ Fir'aun and Thamud and these people who have dominated over the earth and they were so proud and arrogant and they fought against the believers. Where are they? What happened to them? So don't be short-sighted. Allah is always in charge. Allah is always in control. بَلِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فِي تَكْذِيبِ Those who have disbelieved are disbelieving in Allah. They are rejecting the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ مِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ مُحِيطٌ Allah has them in control. If you think Bashar al-Assad is not in control, you're mistaken. Allah allows him to stay in that place, to do what he's doing, because there's a greater benefit for the believers that cannot be achieved otherwise. And that's why Allah is keeping him there. There are people that Allah wants to raise high in paradise. There are believers that Allah wants to awaken. There are believers that Allah wants to bring together. There are believers that Allah wants them to open their eyes to see the blessings of Allah upon them. And the only way to get them to do that is through that trigger, through that tyrant, through that criminal, and through all of those who are with him. And when the whole world lets the believers and lets the Muslims and lets these innocent people down and gives up upon them, and not only that, but conspires even against them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to teach us a lesson. That you should only care about Allah. No one will help you but Allah. Your heart should be attached to Allah. Not to Russia. Not to Iran. Not to Hezbollah. Not to Bashar. Not to America. Not to the UK. Not to Europe. Not to the United Nations. Not to anyone. The only one who can save you is Allah. And when your heart truly connects to Allah, this is when everything starts to change. The whole dynamics of the universe will change. And there are lessons in what's happening for our brothers and our sisters. When we feel the pain, we should feel their pain. And we should feel their pain. And this should awaken us. So we learn the lessons. And we take the ibrah that we make sure we don't end up in a similar position. Because who knows what's going to happen. We should learn the lesson that Muslims should unite together. Stop this kind of sectarianism among Muslims. This kind of hate among Muslims. This kind of division among Muslims. We should stop this. Stop taking the back seat and start doing some real work. Real work in ibadah and real work in real life. Start doing something. Take the lesson. Take the precaution. So what is happening does not happen to you. And what was happening in Iraq, which is exactly what's happening now in Syria. And probably sometimes even worse. The people of Syria, 5-6 years ago, we're living in relatively some kind of luxury and peace. But things change. وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes the states of this world and of these days. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve the plight and the predicament of our brothers and sisters all over the globe. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give a safe escape to our brothers and sisters in Halab and to protect their souls and protect their deen. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring a way out from this whole predicament of what's happening in the Muslim world, in Syria, in Iraq, in Egypt, in Yemen, in Libya, and all the other Muslim countries. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring back peace and justice into this world through His true servants, the ones who truly believe in Him. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Allahumma kun lil mustad'afina minal mu'minina fi kulli makan. Allahumma arham shuhada'ahum. Allahumma arham shuhada'ahum wa taqabbalhum fi s-salihin. Allahumma ihmi mawtahum wa ihfazhum. Allahumma najjihim min aduwwika wa aduwwihim. Allahumma 'alayka bi Bashar wa zumratihi. Allahumma 'alayka bi Hizbillah. Allahumma 'alayka bi Russia. Allahumma 'alayka bi Iran. Allahumma 'alayka bi kulli man تكالب على المسلمين وتآمر عليهم. اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين. اللهم وحد قلوبهم. اللهم اجمع قلوبهم على الحق والتقوى. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم فرج عن أهل حلب واجعل لهم مخرجا آمنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم ارحمهم برحمتك وأنزل عليهم سكينتك ورحمتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.